Overall, the Sooners outscored their opponents by 103 points, set over 15 classic records, and had Stacey King and Mookie Blaylock named to the all-tournament team. The General, who scored 70 points and grabbed 30 rebounds, was named the tournament's most valuable player. Now it was back to Oklahoma for the Sooners and a chance to capture yet another championship. Playing in the all-college tournament, the Sooners faced interstate rival Oral Roberts in the first round. Like others before them, ORU found OU too quick and talented. Harvey Grant scored a career-high 40 points and grabbed 19 rebounds. Mookie Blaylock picked the Titans clean while the Sooners ran away, 144-93. It marked the eighth time in 11 games that OU had snapped the century mark. In the title bout, the Sooners squared off against Illinois State in front of the largest crowd you ever witness a basketball game in the state of Oklahoma, and OU left them wanting more. Once again, Harvey Grant dominated inside while Ricky Grace ran the Sooner offense to perfection. Oklahoma wins their sixth all-college championship and fourth in the last 5 years. Grant and Mookie Blaylock are selected to the all-tournament first team, while Stacey King and Ricky Grace pick up second team honors. After five neutral court games, the Sooners returned to the Lloyd Noble Center and promptly broke the school record for the most 100-point games in a season. OU busted the century mark for the 10th time in 13 games with a 109-69 beating of Austin Peay. The last game before opening Big 8 action, the Sooners did what they do best, forcing 40 turnovers and hitting 53% from the floor. Behind the three-point shooting of Dave Seeger, the Sooners opened conference play with a bang, beating Oklahoma State by the largest victory margin since 1929. Seeger, who tied his own Big 8 record with 8 three-pointers, and Stacey King each poured in 26 points. The Sooners are now 14-0, ranked third of the nation, and appear unstoppable. After suffering back-to-back losses to LSU and at Kansas State, the Sooners found themselves on the road for the third straight game, this time against a stubborn Colorado team. Despite leading by only 3 at halftime, the Sooners started the final half in full stride and never looked back. Oklahoma was back and ready to start another winning streak. It was back to Norman as the 11th-ranked Pittsburgh Panthers came to town in a rematch of a second-round game in last year's NCAA West Regional. Over 11,000 fans jammed into Lloyd Noble Center to see if the Panthers would be the next victim for the Oklahoma pressure cooker. From the start, it was obvious that the OU guards were in control of this game, causing turnovers and feeding the Sooner big men at will. Harvey Grant connected on 12 of 19 shots for 28 points. Mookie Blaylock added 19 points, and Terrence Mullins was called on for a higher level of defense. When Tony Martin connected on this free throw, everyone knew this game was over. It was now time to get serious and concentrate on Big 8 play as the Sooners entered a back-to-back series with 12th-ranked Iowa State. Using balanced scoring again, the Sooners beat the Cyclones 109-86. Setting up the rematch at Ames 2 days later. Harvey Grant led all scorers with 30 points and 12 rebounds, but more importantly, this was the day that a man would be crowned king. Coming off the bench, Stacy King scored 19 points, collected 9 rebounds, and blocked 7 shots in a preview of what was to come. In Ames, with Grant sick and Ricky Grace in foul trouble, King dominated the Cyclone, scoring 36 points and grabbing 21 rebounds in OU's come-from-behind win. To win the conference championship, you have to win the big games on the road, and the Sooners were.
You play smart down the damn stretch. And I tell you what, when you bow up like this and win this one, this is a big one, hey, nothing can stop us. We keep together and you make up your mind what you're going to do. We're going to get that ring.
Missouri, the defending Big 8 champions, were next for the Sooners, and the Big Red literally ran away with this one in a wide-open contest. With two of the all-time greats looking on, Stacy King scored a career-high 40 points and leading OU to its 20th win of the year. It was business as usual when the Sooners visited the Cornhuskers in Lincoln. You better believe they're glad Dave Seeger, Harvey Grant, and Ricky Grace are gone. The three seniors recorded a combined 53 points, 16 rebounds, and 17 assists in this win. The 10th largest crowd in Lloyd Noble history witnessed the Sooners take the inside track for the conference title with a 112-95 win over Kansas State. Once again, Grace and Blaylock stole the show, scoring 20 and 21 points respectively. It marked the 187th OU victory for head coach Billy Tubbs, placing him second on the all-time list.